Good morning. Welcome to Holy Family Parish for the celebration of this Holy Mass. Father Tom will be on vacation starting tomorrow, July 4th, returning Saturday, July 16th. There will still be adoration on Thursday from 5:30 to 7 p.m. and Liturgy of the Word with Communion on Friday at 8:30 a.m. Next weekend, Father Bill O'Brien will be celebrating Mass with us. With Father Tom on vacation, we are looking for volunteers to deep clean the rectory in the next 2 weeks. If a group of parishioners would like to do this as a service to our parish, please contact Deacon Greg. In the narthex are the contribution envelopes for our next fiscal year. Please pick up your envelopes and those of your family and neighbors who may not be coming to Mass. When you drop them off, share Christ with them. There will be a second collection today for the Capital Improvement Fund. Thank you for your generosity. The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few, Jesus laments in today's gospel. Indeed, the kingdom of God is full of plenty, but always there are opportunities to build it up in the way we bring God's love to others. Nourished in the Word and the Eucharist, we go forth to labor for the kingdom. This weekend, we also celebrate the anniversary of our country's founding. Appreciative of what we have while we labor to build a more perfect union. May our labors on behalf of God and country be blessed and fruitful. Our opening hymn is number 766 in the Gather, City of God.
Awake from your slumber, arise from your sleep. A new day is dawning for all those who weep. The people in darkness have seen a great light. Conquered the night. Let us fill the city of God. May our hearts be turned into dancing for the Lord above and above has turned the night into day. Sons of the morning, your daughters of day, the one who has loved us has brightened our way. The Lord of all kindness has called us to be His people to set their hearts free. Let us build the city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing for the Lord our God and our love has turned the night into day.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh and the splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you. Oh God, Almighty Father.
Let us pray. O God, who in the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy, for on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, "Rejoice with Jerusalem and be glad because of her, all you who love her. Exalt, exalt with her, all you who are mourning over her. Oh, that you may suck fully of the milk of her comfort, that you may nurse with delight at her abundant breasts. For thus says the Lord, lo, I will spread prosperity over Jerusalem like a river, and the wealth of the nations like an overflowing torrent. As nurslings, you shall be carried in her arms and fondled in her lap. As a mother comforts her child, so will I comfort you. In Jerusalem, you shall find your comfort. When you see this, your heart shall rejoice, and your bodies flourish like the grass. The Lord's power shall be known to his servants." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm is number 59 in the Gather Book.
Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Let shall the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, may I never boast except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, through which the world has been crucified to me and I to the world. For neither does circumcision mean anything, nor does uncircumcision, but only a new creation. Peace and mercy be to all who follow this rule and to the Israel of God. From now on, let no one make troubles for me, for I bear the marks of Jesus on my body. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with your spirit, brothers and sisters. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Control your hearts. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. At that time, the Lord appointed 72 others, whom he sent ahead of him in pairs to every town and place he intended to visit. He said to them, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest. Go on your way, and behold, I am sending you like lambs among wolves. Carry no money bag, no sack, no sandals. Greet no one along the way. Into whatever house you enter, say first, 'Peace to this household.' If the peaceful person lives there, your peace will rest on him. But if not, it will return to you. Stay in the same house and eat and drink what is offered to you, for the laborer deserves his payment. Do not move about from one house to another. Whatever town you enter and they welcome you, eat what is set before you, cure the sick in it, and say to them, 'The kingdom of God is at hand for you.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
It was a hot summer day in Philadelphia in the year of our Lord, 1776. The room was stuffy. The window was open. A young lawyer, Thomas Jefferson, was sitting at the desk. He was thinking about thoughts all day about a document he was writing. He dunked his pen in the ink. And he began to write one of his thoughts. "We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal and endowed by their Creator with inalienable rights." Powerful words. Eventually, that document became our Declaration of Independence, and we are celebrating that document this weekend. But I need to ask you, is what Thomas Jefferson wrote in that sentence, is it true? Are all men, all people, created equal? If you would have asked any person in the ancient world that question, they would have said, "No, absolutely not. It is more obvious that people are not created equal. People have different skills, different intelligence, different interests. It is more self-evident that people are created unequal." However, there are two words in that sentence that help us as Christians to understand where Thomas Jefferson was coming from. And that is the word created and creator. People are equal in that they were created in the image and likeness of God. All are created with equal dignity. Of course, we are not equal in intelligence and skills and abilities, but they have been loved into existence by a creator. Every human being has absolute dignity from the moment they are conceived until the moment they die a natural death. This is a Christian principle. Without a reference to God, and our dignity coming from God, then this equality that Thomas Jefferson speaks about, it's not self-evident in any way, shape, or form. In fact, powerful figures in history who set aside God also tended to set aside human dignity. Think of people like Joseph Stalin or Mao Zedong. In our country's founders, God is the ground for human dignity. It is the foundation of all the rights that we have. Our rights do not come from the government. Our rights, according to the Declaration of Independence, come from God. This weekend, we are celebrating the independence of our country. No, this is not a holy day. No, this is not something important for our Mass. However, there are very solid Christian themes that intersect. One of those themes that is very important for this day is freedom. Freedom is a central idea for Americans. However, the modern idea of freedom is very different from how Christians use the idea of freedom. Let's just take a moment to explore what freedom is all about. The modern idea of freedom is all about self-expression. I do what I want to do. In this sense of the idea of freedom, it's odd because freedom is seen as more important than truth. Freedom trumps tradition. Freedom at all costs. This type of whatever I want idea of freedom, this is what seems to be celebrated in our movies, in our novels, and as part of our very culture. And yes, even in our legal tradition. Last week, I mentioned that our Supreme Court overturned the case Roe versus Wade. However, there was another abortion case that was overturned as well, and that was the 1992 Supreme Court case called Casey versus Planned Parenthood. In this case, the judges wanted to support abortion. This is one of the quotes from that case. It belongs to the very nature of liberty, freedom, to determine the meaning of one's own life, of existence, and the universe itself. Wow. Did you understand what that meant? This is saying there is no real truth. Truth is whatever I want truth to be. It even says, I decide the very meaning of the universe. My life is about me, nothing else. This is not a Christian understanding of freedom. This is not the freedom of the God who has given us our dignity and our rights. Last weekend, in our second reading, we were reading from Paul's letter to the Galatians just before our reading today. And last weekend we heard, "For freedom, Christ has set us free." And then it continues, "For you were called for freedom, brothers and sisters." But at the same time, when St. Paul was writing to the Romans, he began his letter saying, "Paul, a slave of Christ Jesus, called to be an apostle, set apart for the gospel of God." I'm hoping that causes you to think a little bit. How can Paul be a slave and free at the same time? For our modern concept of freedom makes no sense at all whatsoever. However, with a Christian understanding, it makes sense for Paul to say, I am a slave of Christ, and at the same time, Christ has set me free. You see, true freedom is not opposed to truth. True freedom is not opposed to rules. Here's an example. If someone wants to learn the piano, they submit themselves to rules. They practice every day. They learn the rules of each note. They follow the rules for hand placements on the keys and how to play each different key and how to follow the direction of their teacher, how to count. By working hard, by following those rules, by submitting to a teacher, they learn how to play. And it is only after all of that work are they free to play the piano. Are they free to enter into Mozart, Beethoven, and Chopin? Who is free to play the piano? Someone submitting themselves to rules, practices, and teachers? Or someone who just says, I'm going to do whatever I want and bang on the keys? Now, this goes for anything important in our life. Michael Jordan was free to play basketball brilliantly. Why? Because he practiced, he followed the rules, and he had coaches. To do anything important in life, anything, we will have to work hard. And then working hard, we follow the rules and follow our teachers. And then that allows us the freedom to do those important things in our life. Christian freedom, we submit ourselves to God in the moral law. In this way, as we come to Mass, as we offer ourselves to God every week, as we kneel down by our bed in the morning and the evening as we pray, as we reflect on our lives so that we avoid doing evil and do good, slowly through that work we will grow in our life and Christ and be free from sin and free to live the holiness God calls us to do. We are free to be holy, no longer chained in sin. Modern Americans often think that freedom is to have no rules, do whatever you want, independence from all other people. That will just lead you down a path of emptiness and meaninglessness. Christian freedom is to submit to God so that we are finally free to live in holiness. And in this life in Christ, in this life of love, we will know God and will be filled with joy. In other words, modern freedom is to be free from something. Christian freedom is free for something. And that something is our life in God. We are Christians. So let us now publicly profess our faith. I believe in one God,
maker of heaven and earth,
of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Knowing God's mercy and love, let us turn to him with our prayers and petitions.
For our church, may the Lord raise up holy men and women who humbly labor on her behalf. Let us pray to the Lord. For civil leaders, may the Lord guide them in their work promoting justice, peace, and truth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving that the Supreme Court has overturned Roe versus Wade, we pray that our state upholds the values of life from conception to natural death. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who are sick in this faith community, may God restore them to the fullness of life and health and liberate them from all that afflicts them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, especially Arthur Behnke, for whom this Mass is offered, may they come to share in the fullness of Christ's glory and enjoy his favor forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, in heaven, we come before you with these and all of our prayers. Grant them through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. The offertory song is number 821 in the Gather Book. Prayer of Peace, number 821.
Peace before us, peace behind us, peace under our feet. Peace within us, peace over us, let all around us be peace. Love before us, love behind us, love under our feet. Love within us, love under our feet.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May this oblation dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Let
us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim. We give you praise, Father most holy, for you are great and you have fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love. You formed man in your own image, and you entrusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all the creatures. And when through disobedience he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death, for you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek find you. And time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior, made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners, freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart, joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery which he himself has an eternal covenant. For when the hour has come for him to be glorified by you, the Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread and blessed it, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come.
Therefore, O Lord, as we now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, we remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church. Grant in your loving kindness to all who partake in this one bread and one chalice that, gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis, our Pope, David, our Bishop, the whole order of bishops and all clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into the heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There, with the whole of creation, freed from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not in our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed the man who seeks refuge in him.
Our communion song is in the Missalette, number 288, Come to Me. Number 288 in the Missalette.
Humble of heart.
Now take up our second collection that was announced earlier. Again, this is for the capital needs of our parish. The last time we did this, someone asked, Father, what is that used for? And it's basically used to fix things so we don't have to take up special collections every time something needs to be fixed. For instance, it paid for the lighting. 4 years ago when we got here, we got all new lighting. Recently, it's paid for the new roof. Our roof was over 20 years old and was leaking in places. We didn't have to do a big capital campaign. We had funds. And especially for a lot of the little things that get broken and need to be fixed, that's what this is for, and it's been very, very helpful. So just every month when we take this up, please always be aware that it very much helps our parish and does go into a restricted fund solely for capital needs. Would those bringing communion to the homebound please come forward? You are being sent from this assembly to bring the word of God and the bread of life to the sick and the homebound members of our parish family. We ask you to go to them with our love, with our care, and with our prayers. And we ask you that you do this in the name of Christ Jesus, our Lord and gentle healer. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you very much for doing this. Another thing that we do in our parish that I have always really enjoyed, being Holy Family Parish, we have to recognize how important families are. And as one of the central parts of that is our strong marriages, and to help us to recognize that, I think it's important that we bless anniversaries. So the first weekend of every month, we like to bless everyone who has an anniversary that month. So if you know anyone who is celebrating their anniversary in this month, raise them up in prayer. Also, if you have an anniversary this month, we would invite you to please stand for a blessing. Almighty and eternal God, you have so exalted the unbreakable bond of marriage that it has become the sacramental sign of your Son's union with the Church as his spouse. Look with favor on these couples whom you have united in marriage, in good times and in bad. May they grow in love for each other, and may they resolve to be of one heart in a bond of peace. In their struggles, let them rejoice that you are near to help them. In their needs, let them know that you are there to rescue them. And in their joys, let them see that you are the source of every happiness. And grant peace and comfort to those who have lost their loved ones as they remember their anniversaries this month. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Congratulations. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing song is America the Beautiful, number 984 in the Gather.
Beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grace.